Τρέχει, είναι κανείς εδώ μέσα.
Do you believe in reincarnation? I do. Well, my name is Jeffrey Hendel, and exactly 3 hours ago I died. Well, that is to say, my body died. But of course the soul is immortal. It lives forever. Historians tell us that we learn from the past. So while I'm waiting between lives, if I may, I'll review my mistakes. As lives go, I suppose my last one was rather eventful. I was heir to a large mining empire, which I shared with my late but devoted sister. She always accused me of being irresponsible. However, in the end, I think she may have been more foolish than I.
In a speedy operando. Αν δεν έχω να μου σκίσεις, πίσα βοριά, πίσα νοτιά, μα για δεν έχω να μου λύσεις.
La 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 la
la la la la la la la la la.
Fantastic, man. That is fantastic. I'm sorry I'm a little late, but I want to come by and say hello anyway, because I'm very happy to be here. I like to kiss the betrothed. And I want to sing a little number for you. Get a good start. I'm sorry. Right on. Boy, that stuff will make your belch fire.
Arrested on the charges of an uninformer. He was sitting in the witness chair. Judge's wife called the district attorney. She said, you better arrest that brown eyed handsome man. Flying across the desert.
Too many fans.
I saw a woman walking across the sand. Walking 30 miles in a row to Bombay.
Sit down, love. Sit down.
Έλα, παιδιά, η ορχήστρα, παίξτε λιγάκι.
Εσύ καρδιά
βρε χαρά. Γιατί ανερχάμε στα άστρα και στα γαλάνα νερά. Και στα μαύρα και στα άσπρα δεν σε βρήκα βρε χαρά. Σε ζητήανε ψάμε στα άστρα και στα γαλάνα νερά. Σε ζητήανε ψάμε στα άστρα και στα γαλάνα νερά.
It's Mercury. I've never cheated you.
You wish to count the money?
Okay.
Well, old buddy, that's $173,000 you owe me now.
What's that among friends? A small pittance.
Among friends, a small pittance. But even so, something could go wrong.
Wrong? What could go wrong, Angelo?
Nothing. We help each other, we, look out for each other. We protect each other. Right?
Right.
Hey, do you work out today?
Nope.
Well, you should. You know, like I always said, the body's a beautiful machine, but you got to keep it working smooth. You've got to keep it oiled. I mean, it's a great investment. Pays
back
off at
odds. 1 to 12.
Right. Swim more. Hey, how about tomorrow? You come with me?
Yeah, maybe.
Good. What the hell are you reading? Knowledge is learning acquired before birth. Wow.
Look, why don't I fix you a drink?
No, no, I never think you've seen it. No, but can I borrow the book?
Yeah, but can I borrow some expenses?
You're kidding. bit too much, man. Too much.
One hand, double or nothing.
So long, old buddy.
Why don't you read the chapter on virtue?
Too much.
It's agreed then. I'll do it.
Excuse me. A police escort is here for you, Mr. Edwards.
Thank you. That's fine.
He's waiting outside.
Fine.
Mr. Edwards, you forgot your case.
I'm taking it in for him. It's all right.
Well, fine.
Yes. Oh, excuse me.
It's quite all right.
Πίσω.
David? Hello, David. Welcome.
Sarah, what a nice surprise. How's Nick?
Oh, he's fine, thank you. Look, I thought...
By the way, I forgot to say congratulations.
What?
Your engagement.
Oh, yes, thank you. Look, I thought I'd drive you to the meeting so that we can talk things out and maybe...
That's a lovely thought, Sarah, but you will appreciate how professionally inadvisable that would be the way things are at the moment. As much as I'd love your charming company, I must go. See you later.
Can I give you a lift? Oh. Both?
Why, yes. Thank you.
Good. What about you?
Thank you, but the company car is coming for me.
All right. Well...
Thank you.
Where are you going?
The Mediterranean.
At the same hotel. Please, Mediterranean. Good morning, Mr. Edwards.
Hey, why are you taking me?
Down, boy. Down. Stay down.
Hey, why are you taking me? Help! 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 Help!
Bella.
Pretty, huh? Yes, sir. It's a pretty island. You know, Mr. Edwards, like I told you in the car, we just want a little talk with you, want answers to a few questions, okay?
I will talk only with the proper authorities. I won't talk with scum like you.
You sit down, dummy, and you listen.
I don't care what you know about Jeff. I don't care what you know about the Mercury. I don't care if you know about any of those deals. I care about the will, baby. The holograph will.
How do you know about that? I can't believe it.
You believe it. Old man Hindle was in pain, see? So they spaced him out on morphine, see? So how's he of sound mind, see? How could he write a will, baby? How? Now, if you ain't gonna talk, we don't want to hurt you. But I'll show you. I'll show you what might happen, huh? Ah! Come here!
You okay?
It didn't hurt so much, did it? Huh? You see, if old man Hindle was alive and kicking, you know what he'd say to you? He'd say, hey, dummy, give old Angela the will. Let him mess it up so the original will still applies. And that leave my fortune and all my pretty things to my lovely ones, Jeff and Sarah. Do you see?
The law's absolute. If it isn't, it dies.
Holy God, he don't see. Listen, Mabel, you'll die. You understand that? You will die. Because you're in a very delicate condition. I assure you. Now, let me tell you, 173,000 is a lot of bread, and that's what Jeff owes me, and that's what I owe them. It ain't my money, you see. That's sin money. I didn't make it on the wheel. That's syndicate money. Do you understand? Do you see?
You're just a low-down, cheap loan shark, and you think you've got it made.
Come up here, you bastard. Loan shark, huh? Cheap, low-down loan shark, huh? Is that what you said?
Right on.
Good, huh?
Loan shark.
Το αμάξι χτύπησε στα βράχια, αναποδογύρισε 2-3 φορές και βρέθηκε σε αυτήν εδώ την κατάσταση.
Και ο οδηγός του?
Νεκρός.
Μάλιστα.
Όπου να είναι θα τον βγάλουμε από μέσα.
We've only found one body, the driver's.
So it could be an accident.
Could be.
Then where's Edwards?
We don't know yet. Obviously, he was not in the car.
If he got out of the car before he went over, then he must be around somewhere.
You better think about your own future. I mean it. Hmm? You just don't want to see. All right. I know you're a smart ass. You know about a lot of things. Well, let me tell you, Mabel, I know about a lot of things, too. And I know about water. Right? I know exactly how much water the lungs can take. And, Mabel, I know just how much your lungs can take by looking at you. Now, I'm going to give you a little shot of water. And then you're going to be happy. Happy to tell me about how that old piece of paper is. Hmm? 5 gallons? Fill it up? Well, I'm going to open up. There we go. Gurgle, 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 gurgle.
Hello, I'm Mr. Wells.
Welcome, Mr. Wells.
Do you have a reservation for me?
Yes, sir.
What's that all about? You know, sometimes you scare me to death.
You were supposed to come and see me. You said you were going to come and see me, but you didn't come and see me. Why didn't you come and see me?
Because actually I never wanted to come and see you again. You know, you could have some more consideration. I mean, there is so much for me to do, all sorts of problems, the company. And now Edwards is here, and that can only mean troubles for you. Jeff, You've got to stop spending so much money. I'm telling you, Nicholas is at the end of his rope with you. Understand? For God's sake, will you just listen to me for a minute? I'm trying to help you. All right, I'm sorry. I know I'm preaching again. So, what did you want?
I just wanted to talk to you.
Come on, Jeff, get off.
I mean, can't a brother and sister say hello now and again, especially when she's getting engaged? I have a gift for you.
Give it to me. I love you. Come on. What is this?
It's the tail you pin on the donkey. The one you're gonna marry?
Oh, you're such an ungrateful bastard.
Kentucky Bar and Grill. I'll tell Angela I'll come over.
I came as fast.
Where you been, old buddy? You know, I've been...
So what's the matter with him?
Oh, nothing. He's all right. I tell you something. You know, he
all
ain't
right.
Got it. There's a guy at the hotel that's got it. A guy named Wells. He's got it.
What's he doing? This guy's dead.
No, he ain't dead.
Get off him, for God's sake. Get off. The guy's dead. Turn him over. The guy's dead. What are you doing, drowning him? Come here, help me, will you?
All right, I'm telling
you. Do something, will you?
All I'm telling you, Jeff, you're getting excited over nothing, ain't it? I was an expert lifeguard, remember? All I can tell you, though...
The guy's dead!
You got to go to the hotel. You got to see...
What is everybody just standing around here for?
I can't go. You want to buy?
Get down.
Let me tell you something. You got to go yourself and talk to him. You got to go to the hotel.
I could have handled this. I could have got Nico to do something.
Nico's ain't going to finance you no more. You got to face it, Jeff. And I can't do it. You got to go to the hotel yourself.
I don't have the keys to the city, but I thought I'd stop by and say hello anyway.
Who are you?
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. I'm a client. Client of David's. David Edwards. Jeffrey Hendel. You know, heir to the Hendel fortune, wayward gad about town, no sense of responsibility. You've read about me.
What can I do for you?
Haven't you?
I suppose.
Well, not entirely true, but then again, it's not entirely fiction either. At night, all cats are gray.
Live and let live, that's what I say. Why should I condemn you?
Condemn me if you want to. Applaud me if you want to.
I don't care.
Well, that's not the right attitude, especially not here. We Greeks were forged by philosophy. You should have a philosophy, too.
Are you Greek?
Mother. Ah, there it is. You know, even though I wasn't educated here, I'm very proud of our history, of our ancestry.
Look, I would like to see some of your country. I have no time.
I know what you're thinking.
Yes.
What was our country's finest hour? Well, it was a night, dark like this one, and the moon was a big white eye. You know, they say in Greece that the moon, like the sea, is a mother symbol, and that she's looking down, protecting her children. Demetrius has been ordered to conquer us.
No city is impregnable to me, he boasted proudly. As his hands reached out to snap the neck of the city, we refused to let even the greatest obstacle stand in the way of our history. And that's what you're dealing with here, Mr. Wells. The spirit of gods and kings.
Good evening, sir. Madam.
Good evening. How are you?
Fine.
Any news of Mr. Edwards yet?
No, sir. But perhaps Mr. Wells knows something about him.
Mr. Wells?
Yes, sir. He brought Mr. Edwards' luggage here.
Really? I'd like to go up and see him. Do you want to come?
No, darling. You go up. I'd rather wait here.
As you wish.
Take him up, sir.
Mr. Wells, Portland and Steve.
Φώναξε το διευθυντή γρήγορα.
Ποιος είναι ο αριθμός δωματίου?
126.
Μην μιλήσεις σε κανένα, μόνο στην αστυνομία.
Could have done this.
What makes you think that somebody did this?
Well, I assume.
That's not your job. All you have to do is identify the body, nothing else.
Well, I have. It's Edwards.
By the way, Nick.
Yes?
If you have a moment, come by my office.
Why?
I need your fingerprints.
What for?
You went in the victim's room. Now we need to know which are your prints and which are the killer's.
I'm sticking to oils, natural gas, coal. There's going to be a crisis of energy in the year 2000.
All right, let's put it on a number. Put it on a number. 23 is a hot number, ladies and gentlemen. Round and round, where it goes, no one knows. 18 is an excellent number. A little on the 18, ladies and gentlemen. Have faith in me. Wheat Le Chevaux. Change the ball. Where the ball spins, no one knows. 23! Yeah! What have we over here? A hot table, I hope. Scarlet? Red? Play all the numbers, that way I never lose.
Have you been winning?
Actually, I'm losing. Frankly, Scarlet, I don't give a damn. Colonel? Do I hear a ball spinning?
Put it on every number.
Wheat.
Vegetable.
Wheat not better money.
Oh, my goodness. I can make back the money I've lost.
Oh, I see I've won over at that table, too. Well, let me see. Did someone lose over here? Oh, please, please don't bother. Please, I insist, don't sign your name. It's a family affair. May I? May I just offer all the chips for my lady?
Mr. Chan, come quick.
I'm very worried. There's some very mysterious things happening.
Why should you be worried, Jeff?
Well, it's Mr. Edwards disappeared, and then Mr. Wells committed suicide.
We call it suicide until we have more information.
You know, I demand to know something. Why haven't you interrogated me? I mean, I might have some vital information for you.
Well, if you do, why don't you come to my office? It's always open. I'm always on duty.
Even now?
You see, I'm like a spider. I'm like a flame. I'm waiting for the fly, for the moth to come to me.
And you're confident they'll come to you?
Or they'll ask me to go over to them. Now, don't forget. You are welcome. Anytime.
Close the door, huh? Listen, how many times I gotta tell you to keep away from that goddamn wheel?
Okay.
Okay? My son? Don't smoke in my office. I ain't got no rye.
You got no rye, sweetheart? You got no deal?
You stop that clowning around. I worry, and I don't like to worry. Why don't you come see me? What are you doing talking with that dumb cop down there?
Well, we're just having a little social intercourse about spiders.
I don't give a shit about the sex life of a spider. Did you get it? Huh? You bust that thing?
No, I went to Wells' room. He didn't have it. And he's dead.
He's dead? Wells is dead? You went to his apartment? The man is dead and you still don't have
it? I didn't kill the guy.
But Jesus Christ, what's wrong with you? You did kill him.
I didn't kill him.
You're goddamn insane.
You're the guy who kills people. I don't kill anybody.
That's
just
it. Don't you understand? That's it. Damn it. I don't want that finger pointing at me. With me, it was an accident. The man drowned.
Sure, an accident. What'd he drown of? With a hose in his mouth?
I'll
on land?
They'll
believe that.
We blew it.
You blew it, not me.
Well, this is what we gotta do. My people are pushing me. You gotta come up with the rest of the money you owe me. By tomorrow. Is understood? By tomorrow. I don't care how you get it. I don't care where you get it. You're sitting in the middle of the biggest goddamn pile of shit, and you act like...
Look, just be logical, will you? Think about it for a moment. Now, Edwards didn't have the will, and Wells didn't have it. Somebody had to have it.
Yes.
Somebody who was trained, somebody alert. Think about it.
Pilot, co-pilot, down
no.
The stewardess? Oh, you're kidding.
Stewardess? Sure, stewardess had it.
Oh, come on. He
wouldn't
give it to a goddamn stewardess.
That's who got it.
Okay. That'll be something. Okay, I'll buy that. Stewardess, right? You think that Wells give it to her, huh?
Sure, you just sit there and eat your sandwich, and I'll take care of everything, okay?
Hey, you gotta find that goddamn broad. Pick her up.
Okay.
And listen, you take it easy, huh?
Right.
And you keep away from that goddamn wheel. Is that clear?
One hand, double or nothing. You just blew it, sweetheart. Cinq, six,
six,
neuf, quinze, dix-huit. 21. What happened here? Everybody died. Put a little money on the table. A little action here.
Trente-trois,
trente-six. Let me know how I come out.
Yeah.
Nice of you fellas to take me to the toilet with a paper train.
Well, look, what do you think Humphrey Bogart would do in a case like this? Do you think you'd ever see a grown man cry?
Angelo, what are you doing to me?
Come up here.
This is stupid.
You never will learn. I told
this
you
to hurt you more than God.
No, this is for your own good, buddy.
The rest of your life, you'll regret this.
For your own good.
Hey!
You okay, old buddy? Get him up. Yeah. Now, are we learning something?
Smart ass.
When it's springtime in the Rockies, in the Rockies.
Hey, Nikos. Hell of a place to talk turkey, huh? Pretty good. Come on, get soaked up.
They just fished Edwards' body out of the sea.
Edwards? Huh? Which Edwards? Man, I know a million of them. There's Sam and Billy and Mac the Gimp Edwards. Hey, you know those Turks are smart bastards. I mean, they really are.
I found Wells strung up in his room. Two suicides doesn't make any sense.
Make sure
the ink doesn't run.
What the hell is it?
Not to forget about Jeff.
That looks like 10 grand.
I figured you wouldn't settle for that. Okay. How much? 12? 15.
That's toilet paper, Buster. That ain't enough for a tip from my masseuse. Don't you know that dummy owes me close to 200 grand? That's three zeros with a two in front.
200,000?
That's right.
I can't put all that money together. Who the hell do you think you are?
Who the hell do I think I are? Well, I'll tell you. I am Angelo, the son of a bitch. A poor son of a bitch, because my daddy didn't have money to send me to school like you rich, educated bastards. You make me puke. You think you can write a check, buy off anything, a baby, a murder, anything? Huh? Well, this time you're wrong, Buster. You are wrong. I don't give a damn if you own real estate, freeholds, the whole goddamn mining land, the whole ocean, everybody in it.
I can put you to jail.
If you do, there'll be blood. And I ain't kidding. You're strictly Bush, Mr. Bush. You blow the whistle on me. And you and sweet little Jeff and Sarah, all three of you, ain't worth a good goddamn. You got that?
She's a Cocker Spaniel and a poodle. Some call her Cockapoo, but I call her Spadoodle.
Would you mind if I sat down?
Of course not.
You're a stewardess, aren't you?
Yes. How do you know that?
Well, it's a small island. You know, I don't understand how they can put you in that hotel the airlines uses. Oh, here, let me help you. It's American, isn't it?
Are you American?
A mother. You know, that place is for $5 a day tourists with only one change of clothes. What you ought to do is stay in my hotel.
Your hotel?
Gotta burn the furniture, warm the place up.
Oh, you're crazy.
Come on. I am cursing. I'm gonna kill you.
You think you're that good, huh?
Mm-hmm. I'm gonna wipe you out. I just thought you ought to know that.
Well, come on, then.
Leave me alone.
Who were they with on the plane? Tell me.
Who were they with on the plane? Huh? Who did they sit with? Or
Edgar!
Talk?
Edgar!
A girl. What was her name?
I don't know.
Tell me her name.
An American girl.
American girl?
Yes.
What was her name? Huh? Tell me her name.
I don't know.
Yes, please. Tell me her name.
Photojournalist, please leave me.
A photojournalist?
Yeah.
What did she do?
I don't know.
What was her name? Tell me her name.
Laura.
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 Only part of you's gonna die. Body dies, but the soul's immortal. That's what's important. You know, death isn't as bad as they try and tell you it is. Because the soul's lived before, and it'll live again. The soul never dies. Don't worry.
Listen to me. Can you hear me? I'm going to take care of everything. You get dressed. We have to get out of here fast. Give me that sheet.
get up from there.
Sorry that I had to leave, but it was Jeff again. He was so upset about not being invited to the party. We ended up having a big fight. Shh, I can't talk now. Okay, darling, I'll speak to you tomorrow morning then. Fine. Okay, have a good night's sleep. Bye-bye.
Don't tell me it's Jeff again.
So what if it was?
At this hour?
Nikos, you got to leave me alone. I mean, I have so many problems.
Then tell me your problems. I want to know. I want to help, can't you see? Get rid of them.
Excuse me, Nick. I hope I'm not disturbing you so late at night.
Don't you ever sleep?
Nobody's ever caught me at it.
Look, this is a bad time.
That's okay. I've got bad news. Well, won't you bite me?
Sure.
Thank you. Hello, Sarah.
Well?
Oh. Wells didn't hang himself, although they tried to make it look as though he did. But he's been strangled by person or persons unknown.
Oh, my God.
Which means that Edward's car didn't fall off the road accidentally.
Yeah, looks that way. Sure does. Better let you get back to whatever you were doing before I barged in like this. Good night, Sarah.
Good night.
Nick.
Didn't you have something to tell me?
Yes, Nikos, that I'm tired and I want to go to sleep. I'll see you in the morning, okay?
Hit the deck, Sarge! They're crowds! They're firing right back!
Come on, Dad.
I say, sir, forgive me, but I didn't ring for the seconds because I didn't receive the old formal governor paper.
I thought we should talk.
Oh, you mean we're not going to try and kill each other? What a pity.
See, that's the trouble. We don't know each other.
We don't know each other because we don't like each other.
I suppose it's more my fault than yours.
Yeah. 10 paces. One.
You know,
two.
All my life, I worked very hard to get where I am.
Four, five.
I never had the time to get to know people
six,
like you.
Seven, eight, nine, ten. Like me.
What am I, some kind of a freak?
Well, that's not very funny. And certainly not sporting.
Do you know that Hemingway used to do this every morning? Just a little bit more pressure right here until...
Jeff!
Oh, Mr. Crockett, forgive me. He was the biggest old woodcock you ever saw. Vittles for everybody. We'd have fed the whole regiment. I missed it. Damn, I missed it, Mr. Crockett. Oh, damn. Come back, woodcock.
You know, it might solve things if you got out of the country for a while. Straighten up your mind.
Sure. You get me out of the way while you enjoy my sister here in peace. Well, it's not going to be the way you think.
What's that supposed to mean?
You think she's a marvelous person. Well, she's not.
What are you talking about?
She wants to control you. She wants you to be her little puppet. To be a prisoner. A slave.
Tell me, Jeff. Did you and Sarah have a fight last night?
Me and Sarah? I haven't seen her in weeks. What are you talking about? Certainly not last night.
Okay.
Listen, Jeff.
Damn it, I didn't have to do that.
Sure you did. It was for my own good.
You're absolutely right. You know, Jeff...
Forget it, okay?
Okay. What's going on around here?
Huh?
Come on, old buddy. Don't I know you good? Who are you working with? Come on, you can tell me.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Sure you do. Listen, old buddy. No way you could kill anybody. No way. Hey, let's go for a spin, okay?
Okay.
Fresh air. Great, huh? No pollution. How you feel?
Tired.
You ought to quit that smoking. It's gonna kill you. Hey, old buddy. Hey, we out far enough?
Uh-huh.
Hey. What do you know about turkey?
What kind of turkey? Thanksgiving turkey?
Nah, turkey. That's it. Way over there. That's turkey. You know about Greece, what do you know about turkey? Hey, you know something, old buddy? We ought to just keep going and lose ourselves there in the land of the Turk. Then you wouldn't have to pay me back, and I wouldn't have to pay me back. I wouldn't have to pay my people back.
We could never come back.
Well, who the hell wants to go home again anyway, huh? Hey, you ought to quit that smoking. It's gonna kill you. Time me. I'm going in. Okay? Like I told you, the body's an investment. You take care of it, it'll take care of you.
1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. You can do it. Come on.
Sure I can. Everybody should be able to. They ought to teach you like this in schools, old buddy. Hit the throttle.
Do you mind if I put it on automatic pilot? My arms are getting a little tired.
Me, I'm doing fine. Just fine, old buddy.
I'm clocking you, and the time is running out. Edgeo! What'd you say? The markers are down?
What?
You're right about cigarettes. They're a killer. They'll give you cancer. Did you get to the chapter on the immortality of the soul?
Jeff, who the hell is that?
It's a pity.
Jeff, get him away from there. Jeff! Get that bugger out of there.
Bye-bye, Angelo. So long, Angelo. So long, Angelo.
You are too well known in this community to do anything unwise, irrational, destructive, or so I thought. They found your prints on the case, and they are the only prints in the room.
So why don't you throw me to jail?
Listen, I don't want to lose my investment in the Hindle companies, and somebody has been siphoning the mercury deposits. Edward was coming to report to me on his findings. And when I saw the case in Wells's room, by natural impulse, I opened it. I didn't touch anything else.
I'd wonder whom you're protecting if I didn't know you. Sarah is involved, isn't she? Or maybe you suspect Jeff.
Either you charge me or let me get out of here.
We are old friends. I wouldn't like my friends to worry.
But then put my mind to rest.
Both murders are totally different in conception and execution. And I don't think that either of the killers is Jeff.
If it isn't him, who is it then?
Actually, there are two killers and not one. But for the moment, let's assume that we are looking for a mysterious Mr. X. You may go now.
Can you imagine what it was when the gods were here?
Hello. Let me get a picture of you like that, with your gods beside you.
You know, the camera can only record. It can't capture the feeling.
What is this? It's lovely.
Very old, very ancient coin. Atlantis, Minoian.
I've never seen anything like it. Looks like it should be in a museum.
It belongs around your neck.
Oh, no, I couldn't take it. No.
No, I insist. It's a gift.
It.
Yes,
no.
You must.
Thank you. But you know, the Indians say you must return a gift with a gift.
And I say a gift must be precious.
Is it really from Atlantis?
You know, I've dreamt about it all my life. Ever since I was a little boy. It's very real, you know. It does exist.
I've always thought that. It's always fascinated me. Ever since I was a little girl.
Now listen to me. We have to go through with it, you understand? Now, I don't want any problems from you. Okay, darling, listen, we'll be free after that, you understand? We can go anywhere you want. Please, look, I'll be there exactly at 11:30. Wait for me. Okay.
Sorry, I didn't mean to scare you. I knocked at the door, and there wasn't any answer, and the maid let me in. I brought you these books. I thought you'd like them. No. Please, I didn't mean to scare you, really.
It's all right.
Would you prefer that I wait downstairs? I don't mind.
No, it's all right.
You sure?
No. Fix yourself a drink. No, really, it's all right. Go ahead. Stay a while. I'll be out in a minute.
You're sure? Sure. Zara, good evening. Did I startle you? I'm very sorry.
Oh, that's okay. Do you want to come in?
But you're about to leave, weren't you?
Oh, not really. I was just going to put the car in the garage. You want to talk to Nick?
If he's home.
No, actually, he's at the meeting.
Frankly, I'd really like to talk to you. If you can spare the time, of course.
May I offer you a drink?
Yes, thank you.
That means you're not on duty tonight.
Actually, I am. But I guess I can have an orange juice.
Let me open the window.
No, don't do that. You'll catch a cold after you've taken a shower.
God, have you ever seen such a beautiful moon? I have an idea. Why don't I call downstairs and get them to get some food, and we can go across and have a picnic and a swim. Wouldn't that be terrific?
Mm-hmm.
Don't you want to?
Sure I do.
All right, you call downstairs while I go and get changed. I'll be 2 minutes.
Well, I suppose if we must have the death penalty, I think we should bring back public executions, don't you?
I don't think we should have death penalty.
I wonder, is everyone capable of being driven to murder?
I could.
What would drive you to murder?
Well, let's say if I had a son and somebody tried to hurt him, I would kill. I would absolutely kill.
That's fascinating. But you're not a mother. Suppose we take another possibility. Now, you and Jeff are used to having more money than most of us, aren't you?
Yes.
And you are very privileged people. Suppose suddenly that your sources of income were cut off. Would you kill to get them back?
Oh, that's absurd.
Let's make it less absurd. Now, suppose that Hindle had made out a new will, cutting you and Jeff off without a penny. And suppose that nobody knew about that, but the pair of you.
We would get an accusation to murder. Now, if you really believe that's the case, why don't you do something about it? Why don't you arrest us? Just stop playing games.
Then, if I had that new will in my possession, I'd have the perfect motive to arrest you, wouldn't I? Yeah. So the game is over. Read it. It's such a pity, but my marvelous motive has gone up in smoke, hasn't it? Now that Nikos has been given full charge of the Hindle estate, obviously I have no motive to arrest you. Well, you must admit that it was an interesting theory while it lasted. I must be going now. Good night, Sarah.
Hello, Miss Ryman, please.
Ryman's not in.
Thank you.
You ever walked into a room, a totally unfamiliar room, and know that you've been there before?
Do you know once a clairvoyant told me that in one of my earlier lives I was an Indian princess?
Well, that's exactly how I feel about Atlantis. I know I've been there. I know I've seen it. I know everything about it. I know I lived in that time.
Jeff, nobody knows if Atlantis really exists. I mean, it's just a dream. It's a concept.
It's a place.
But you need experts. Archaeologist.
I don't need anybody. I know exactly where it is. I could take you right now. We could leave together. I know I've been there. I know I live there.
It's a beautiful dream, Jeff. But it's crazy. And we just can't go off sailing around the world together. I want you to get on the boat with me now. Now, you understand? No! 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 Come here.
Sorry.
I've had enough of you. I really do.
Stay away from me. You'll be sorry. Sarah made love to her brother!
Love
Jeff, we have to run. Jeff, we have to run now. Jeff! Jeff, they're after us. Jeff, if we don't run now, we'll never be safe.
Γρήγορα το τζαρνάκι, την κάνετε εδώ πέρα, κάντε γρήγορα. Και εσείς κουνηθείτε, μπρος. Ειδοποιήστε να έρθει και ένα στενοφόρο.
It worse. Come down.
Fire a warning shot.
Don't shoot. Please. Please tell him not to shoot. I'll go up. I'll talk to him. I'll bring him down. I promise I can talk to him. Please, please let me go up there. Please.
All right. I'll give you 5 minutes. But only 5 minutes. And then I'll come and get you, both. Block all exits from the walls. Hurry.
I want you to take the wheel. I'll go below and fix provisions for the crew. Hmm? All right? Okay, get in there. You take the wheel, and I'll be below deck. Mr. Christian, prepare the royal champagne.
Jeff, do you think we'll be free and we can do anything we want and go anywhere?
I don't want to hear one negative thought. Not one negative thought out of you. I am the captain of the boat, and the captain's word is law.
Champagne, my darling, champagne. You know, no one's ever liked my Cary Grant impression. Hello, my darling. If I only had the wings of a bird, we'd fly away.
Oh, that is the worst champagne I have ever tasted. 399 B.C., Socrates.
I prefer to bathe myself rather than have the women wash me when I'm dead. Mm. Oh, wow. They wouldn't let us live the way we wanted to. Well, they can't tell us how to die. Good to the last drop. Hemlock.
You are joking.
Well, don't worry, there's none near us. You know, it's the funniest thing. My feet are supposed to be numb, and then it moves up the body into the legs, and I don't feel a thing. It's not numb. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm going to fix this a little bit more sham. Now, Spike, pay.
No.
I want you to hold me. Hold me tight. I want you to listen to me because everything's going to work out all right. Don't you understand? You'll take the little boat and you'll go back and you'll have it all on your mad brother. Don't you understand?
Weirdest feeling I have ever felt in my life. I've got my legs are absolutely numb, and my heart is beating just it's beating as fast as.
Ειδοποίησε το λιμεναρχείο γρήγορα. It's only a plastic boat in a great big bathtub. I can pull the plug anytime I want. Come, let's have a cup of Greek coffee now. Let's go.
All I want to do now is get drunk.
And we'll live again. A heartbeat in time.
Thank you.